We're going to build this liquid animation you see on the screen right now. We're also going to learn how to do fire and some other special effects using the same techniques. We're going to start right now. Okay, let's start by drawing our central circle. And I'm going to make a copy of a smaller circle going this way, maybe about like that, and another one here on the other side. They're equally spaced. Let's get the whole contraption centered on the page like that. Perfect. Let's fill these with black. All right, let's group these together because I want to apply a blur here, but only to these circles, not to the whole frame. So I've got my group selected. I go to Effects and add a layer blur. I think maybe enough so that the blurs don't quite touch. You don't want them to actually meet, but almost meet, something about like there. Now on top of this, I'm going to put a gray rectangle. And let's make it about 50% gray, which is 80, 80, 80. I can just type 80. And I want to apply a blending mode on here of color dodge. This basically removes any pixels from the original image that are lighter than 50% gray. So far, so good. Now we add another rectangle on top of this one. This one is going to be filled with black. And the blending mode for this layer will be color burn. And this basically cranks up the pixel value of anything that survived the last filter and makes it all black. So anything that's not white is 100% black. And let's leave it at that for now. I just want to show you how this is working. I'll click on one of these ellipses and I'll just move it with the Y here. Watch what happens. Isn't that beautiful? This little liquid effect that's happening as it gets closer. Okay, let's move it back. If you wanted to add a color or image on top of this, you can do that by adding yet another layer. Let's put a blend on it. And I'll make it from red to blue, maybe, just to make it dramatic. And then the blending mode for this layer is screen. And now we've created a beautiful blend that has this effect. And as we move the circles around, the fills stay stationary, but the circles move. Isn't that cool? One, this is meant to be a menu, so let's put a little X on it. This is in the open state, so we would have an X. I'm just going to use the pen tool here, do a 45 degree, escape, do another one here and here, return, and I'll make it white. And I'll make it thicker. And I'll give it rounded ends. And of course, I'll center it here. All right, so far, so good. Now, how do we animate this? Well, let's just do a quick animation. I will make a copy of this. Now, it can be tricky to select these circles in the back here. So I'm just going to hold down the control key, right click, and it lets you pick which layer you want. I want this ellipse right at the bottom, and I'm just going to move it with this Y tool here. I want to put it right about there, just inside the circle. And same with this one. I hold the control key down, right click, pick the ellipse at the back, and I'm going to change the Y here to just inside the big circle. So now we've got our open and closed state. Now we just need to turn our X into a plus, so that we get a little animation of that plus rotating as well. Let's rename this frame to closed. I'll set up the prototype behavior to be very simple. Just click anywhere on the frame. It'll take us over to the other one. On click, navigate to open menu, smart animate. We'll keep it at 2 seconds just so we can see the animation more clearly. And I like ease in and out back. It gives that nice bounciness to it. And let's make sure, of course, that we do the click in the opposite direction as well. So once we get here, we can go back. And on click, navigate to close, smart, yeah, it looks great. I'm going to click on the closed menu here, shift spacebar to open up the preview window. And let's click on it and see what happens. Oh, that's very slow, but it gives you a nice view of that gorgeous animation as the liquid effect comes when the circles are close enough and disappears automatically. I love it. I think in reality, we'd probably make this about 300 to 400. Let's just make it 300, see how that goes. And I'll open closed menu, shift spacebar. Yeah, a little perkier, but you still get a hint of that liquid effect. So somewhere in between, you'll have to just play with the timing, just getting that nice balance of responsiveness and yet still being able to see that beautiful liquid effect as it spreads apart. So you might wonder how this actually works, and I wanted to break it down so that you're not just following steps click by click, but actually understand what's going on. And it's actually really interesting what happens in between the original artwork layer all the way up to the final result. So I'm going to walk through the 5 layers that are involved in building this. so that you can understand what actually is happening at each layer. The original artwork is simple enough. This is just our circles that are moving. We've applied a blur, which gives us a gray zone that we can work with for the liquid effect to work in. The next layer, color dodge, for now, let's just make it a 50% gray layer. There's other tricks we can do with it, but for now, 50% gray removes any pixels that are lighter than this gray. Color burn is applying what is essentially a high contrast filter so that anything that is not white becomes black. And then screen does a very similar operation. It just applies whatever is in the screen layer to wherever black pixels appear beneath. All of these layers are necessary to pull this off, but this can be a handy reference to make it easy for you to build these things quickly. I have a copy of this diagram that you can find a link on the description. So I got a little curious. What if instead of a flat 50% gray layer here, there was actually a little bit of noise or texture in the color dodge layer? What would happen? Would I get kind of a textured edge around the side of my circle instead of this beautiful smooth one? Let's try it. I'll take a copy of my closed menu here. I'll delete this because I'm really only interested in the circle. Now the layer that had the color dodge was this one here, gray. And you can see it's got color dodge as the blending mode. I'm going to replace it with this textured gray image instead. So I'm going to copy this. I'm going to highlight the gray layer here. And I'm going to do a Command-Shift-R to replace it. I have to reset the blending mode. That seems to get replaced back to color dodge. Okay, my circle's already a little weird looking. Let me zoom a bit here. Now I'd like to highlight the image, which of course is much bigger than the frame. If I just move this, I'll use the Y controller here. Look what happens to my circle. Because the noise is kind of blurry itself, I get this nice, smooth, warbling circle here. Isn't that incredibly cool? This is a way of animating shapes in sort of a random, goopy way. Well, then I was thinking, well, maybe I can build my own noise textures right here in Figma using the blur effect on layers and get some other textures aside from just random movements. I wanted to experiment with moving the gray texture behind the circle from flat gray, which we know will just give a nice smooth circle, transition into doing lines, and then back again to flat gray. What would that look like? So here's what it looks like. I've got it also set up behind the circle. So as I move it, you'll see the effect and see what image is behind it over here on the left. So as I change this position here, watch what happens as the lines start to kick in. You start to see the effect of these lines on the circle. This is just so unbelievably cool. So any texture you can think of that you can convert into a grayscale like this, you can use to modify the edge transition between circle and white as it moves. This is just so cool. And then whenever you want it to transition smoothly back to flat again, you just gradually have it go back to a nice flat gray, and it just gradually goes back to smooth. That is just so cool. I couldn't believe it. So you're only limited by your imagination, what these textures are and how it impacts your circle. Well, the next thing that crossed my mind was, could we do something like a flame flickering, you know? So I tried something similar. I built a blurred flame icon, and this is the texture we're going to scroll behind it using this same technique. And just look how cool this is. Watch. Watch what happens as this moves. The flame starts to undulate. Oh, yes. Isn't that awesome? Oh, my God. And then it settles down again. You can imagine you might want to animate this when someone puts their mouse over an icon, or maybe it's just constantly animating when you're on the page, like an animated logo, without the need to do complicated animation elsewhere. Very cool. So I was trying a colored logo where we color the flame from red to yellow just to see how that looks when it moves. And I couldn't believe what happened. So as this texture starts to come up, look at that. Not only does it undulate, the color moves along with the ramp. This is just way beyond my expectations. This looks so cool. It's like burning fire in Figma just by moving a layer up and down. Couldn't believe it. I did not expect that. Again, by accident, I was just experimenting and stumbled on this, where when we move this texture behind a color ramp like this, we get the full background in flame mode and the undulating flame, and I got this beautiful gradual in and out flame effect that you can imagine using in all sorts of ways. Here's a couple other experiments that I came up with, again, mostly by accident. But look at these beautiful effects that you can get using these layer blending modes. So cool. So I wanted to test this on top of other artwork as well. So here I've placed something with this same effect going on. And as I move the background noise, you can see that you're able to animate your artwork on top of other artwork just fine. So I can imagine using this for twinkling stars or for water ripples, all sorts of things you could do to make your screens look more engaging, or your micro interactions as you hover over things could cause or other effects. I got this image from a website that lets you generate noise images, something called Perlin noise, P-E-R-L-I-N. If you do a search for that term, you'll find lots of sites that generate it for you. I'll also provide a link in the description of this video to one, but as I say, they're not hard to find, and most image editing programs probably also have a feature that will generate noise for you as well. Just make sure that it's blurred a little bit like this for a best effect. So that was an interesting journey. I mean, what started off as a very simple exploration of doing that liquid effect suddenly turned into fire and all sorts of other cool stuff that I discovered along the way. Hopefully that was interesting for you. This is a topic in particular where it's going to be very helpful for me to give you a file to download with examples of all the things I just walked through, so you can dismantle them, see how they work. And plus, I've got that reference diagram that shows how the layers all work together if you just want a quick reference and want to build something quickly. It doesn't take that long once you get used to it, and it's super useful. Adds a little bit of flash or interest when you've got animations that take advantage of these little effects. So have fun, and I'll talk to you again soon.